Guys, welcome to a new vlog. Vlogging on a new camera. Like I mentioned in the last vlog, I was going to get a new one. This has got a flippy out screen, but it's to the right of the camera as opposed to above. So if I start looking over here, like I'm looking beyond you all, I'm just checking myself out basically. I am just about to go out. I have not been good today. I'm actually, I hope the tumble dryers on, that'd be too noisy. Just gonna pop you down somewhere. I have bought myself with this camera a tripod, but I'm in a rush on the way out and I haven't set it up yet. And it's a fancy tripod that helps record things, but for now you're on top of a candle. I am about to head out. It's 4 o'clock, I've not left the house all day. And I have wallowed in a pile of tears and snot and misery all day, and anxiety all day. The new announcements regarding London moving into the middle tier in terms of where the risk level is for coronavirus have felt like they have come and punched me clean in the face of just everything we're all feeling this year. Like, you've got no capacity to plan for any kind of future, and any attempt to do so feels futile because it just comes whoop right from under you. It's something I'll talk about maybe when I'm feeling less, like, you know, when you cried so much your head hurts and you feel puffy and not, I feel cloudy basically. So maybe I'll try and speak more coherently about it. But the point I wanted to make at this moment in time was that I have just booked to go to the 4:45 slot at the National Gallery. I thought, do you know what? If you sit in all evening, you'll just cry. And sometimes it's fine. I'm actually a big advocate for a really, really big cry. And I'm a big fan of one, but you also then kind of need to know when to try and stop. Sometimes you can't stop, and that's also fine, but the effort to stop eventually has to be made, and I'm making that effort now. And yeah, I'm gonna go out, go to the National Gallery. If I cry in the National Gallery, I'll just put it down to being totally overwhelmed by the artwork, if anyone asks, which nobody would, because this is London and people don't stop and ask you if you're okay, if you're upset. So that's my plan. Like I said, I was sitting about, I literally sat about and stared at my emails and like replied to some and then thought that sentence doesn't make sense. It's been that day. So it's time to go out, and then I'll have to work this evening and get my stuff done that I haven't gotten done, but maybe that will feel way more possible once I'm back in and had some fresh air and a change of scene rather than just moping and feeling sorry for myself. So that's the plan. Me, you, the new camera are going to go out. In that list, I realised I should take a handbag. I'll take this one as it's here. All my handbags have like a load of shit in the bottom of them. This one's got some receipts, two hair bubbles, a lip balm, about £2.50. I'll fill that bag up and then off we go. Oh, actually, I'm just using the bag I took yesterday. That's already filled and ready to go. What am I thinking? Okay guys, back home. I've set up my fancy new tripod thing, hence all these instructions everywhere. It's one of those things where I got it out of the box and thought I can do this without checking the instructions, but couldn't. Let's head upstairs and take off my coat. I really enjoyed that. I didn't film too much going around because I always feel like even though you are allowed to take photos in galleries, that someone is going to walk in and be like, oh, you with the camera, stop it. But I really enjoyed it. I didn't give myself enough time for it because I only was there an hour before it closed. And you definitely need longer than that. But like I said in my last vlog, I've booked to go and see the Artemisia exhibition. So that should be fine. Excuse me while I get to grips with this. Just setting up my little tripod. Okay, that doesn't look great. Oh. Just take my coffees. And I'm gonna order myself something off Deliveroo. I don't feel like cooking. I don't know what I fancy though. My my go-to is normally a pad thai, which is just so good from this Thai place near me. It's so delicious. So yeah, I hope you guys are all feeling okay. I still feel hugely out of sorts, but oh god, I think it's just one of those. Sorry. Back downstairs, guys. What shall we have? So yeah, I still feel massively out of sorts, but just one of those days. It will pass. I feel like there's just so, like I said earlier, so much that's so wildly out of control, and then I'm the kind of person that when that happens, I become really stressed about the things that are within my control and are really overly anxious and over emotional about stuff as well. So just not been a good day. So I think it's kind of one of those things as well, there's not much to say about it or there's not much to talk through about it, because it just, we are where we are and we have to make the most and work out how to. And I do feel better for having walked around the gallery and stuff, but it hasn't. Oh, dish humes on Deliveroo. That's kind of, that might cheer me up. But it hasn't. I still feel a bit off. So I just think that's one of those days, which is also fine. And you just have to roll with it and go with it all and order a takeaway that makes you feel a little bit better. I need to concentrate this and decide what I want, but you guys will be the first to know. I went for Nando's, which I definitely don't normally do, but I saw it on there and thought, oh, do you know what, I could. So I will, and I have, and I shall. Can you hear that television from my next door neighbour? Does anyone need to listen to the television that loud? It's driving me mental. This is like a thing she's only started doing in the past few months. I do not remember this being part of my life last year. It's so loud. So loud. Oh god, I look knackered. I've got a spot here. That has to be mask caused. Why else would you have a spot there? I've never had a spot there in my life. It's Friday morning. I'm just getting ready to go to the gym. Just forgetting what step I was on my skincare then. Yeah, I'm just getting ready to go to the gym. Hopefully we'll make it feel a bit better, we'll see. I slept really well, but still feel pretty bleh. I have been looking online this morning at alarm clocks. So I think I mentioned in the vlog, I've got an eyelash going away. There we go. I think I mentioned in a vlog the other week that I am like super conscious of my screen time. Do you ever just get to the end of the day and you're like, God, I'm like shit. And you feel like I've done nothing but sit on my phone. And then look at your screen time and you'll be like, that's because that seems to be all I've actually done. And of course it doesn't make you feel good. And so I'm really trying to not be on it as much. And what I'm, like with the news yesterday, with the way things are going towards another lockdown or whatever, when I'm spending loads of time on my own, that's when I'm on my phone loads, which I think is pretty understandable. When you're socialising with people, I think I would rarely be on my phone in the same way. So it's days like yesterday where I'm mostly by myself that I will just be constantly picking it up, and I'll pick it up again and I'm like, oh, you've just been on this. There's nothing new on here for you. Why are you constantly picking it up and just scrolling through the same app? It's not even interesting. So a big one for me is in the morning, like that seems to be when I do it the most. And so maybe if I can crack the morning routine with it, the rest will fall into place. So this long spiel was basically saying that I think I'm gonna get an alarm clock and then sleep with my phone downstairs. So then the only thing you need your phone by your bed for ever is for an alarm or to know what the time is if, like me, you wake up in the middle of the night and feel disoriented. So that's my plan. I'm trying to decide, do I get one of those Lumi ones that light up? Don't know how much I need that. I can't decide. I'm probably going to regret saying that in like a month when it's dark so early. But I can't decide whether I'll benefit from that or for the same price, get a Google Nest Hub where you can like connect your lights and stuff to it. Do I want that or do I not? Or do I just get a really bog standard alarm clock, just a digital alarm clock that you just hit on and off? I can't decide. So that's today's absolutely aching dilemma. Stressful life, I'm sure you all can imagine. So yeah, if any of you have any of those, do let me know. I think maybe Google Nest would be good with like the radio on, or I could put on, I could have like a morning playlist set up if I can connect it to the Sonos, so that in the morning the lovely music comes on through the house. Or is that just stupid? Who knows, but I need to do something that gets me off my phone. Yesterday I was on my phone for 6 hours. I looked yesterday. How bad is that? There's always an element of it where I'm like, I work on my phone, so that I'm allowed more than the average person, I would say. But 6 hours is not okay. I want my average to be 4 hours a day. That's my goal. Maybe we'll make this thing, because I think lots of people will struggle with their screen time on their phone, and also being quite embarrassed to admit it, because it's not very cool to say, yesterday I spent 6 hours on my fucking phone. Do you know who's also to blame? TikTok. Just lose hours to that app. Did the gym, which was good but hard. Having another indoors day today because I've got some logs being delivered. I told you about the log thing, didn't I, last time. So, and they give you the really handy window of any time between 12 and 6. So that's great. So I'm just in all day, waiting for that to happen. I'm really hoping Frank will come over, but he doesn't come over that often anymore. And I think it's because it's so cold, so the doors never open. And he normally comes around like if he can hear people chatting or whatever, or when I was in and out of the garden. And I do try and open the door for a little bit every day on the off chance he'll want to come around, but I haven't seen him in about a week. And I also get the impression he's maybe a fair weather outdoor cat, and when the weather's cold and miserable, he's probably just enjoying his time in his own home, which is very selfish. It just makes me want to get my own cat so badly. But I can't while I live here, unfortunately. Otherwise, definitely would. I'd be adopting a little rescue kitty. Anyway, got my cup of tea now. I'm just gonna crack on with some work while waiting for several bags of logs to arrive. Hello guys, sat in the same spot as yesterday, still puffing because there has been more tears. But I've just had some good news that I want to share with you all, which is my landlady said that if I would like to, I could get a cat. Which I'm so, it's something I've wanted for ages, and oh, she's just texted me again. No problem. I have an old friend who rescues cats as a serious hobby. He lives in Dalston. If you wanted to put me in touch. Oh. Do you remember very slightly as woodburner tends to shrink the floorboards a bit as it sucks moisture out of the air. Ooh. Okay, no. Sorry, guys. This is like when you meet up with a friend and they're like, well, sorry. Well. Yeah, so she'd said, I thought I'd ask. I always thought it was an option because it's in my contract that it's not. And I do understand why, like, landlords don't want people to have pets. I get that. But with cats especially, most of the things, you know, a dog, I suppose, can chew, like, corners of kitchen cabinets and things and scratch doors, whereas cats generally, most in my experience, cats we've had like scratching carpets and fabric furniture. Well, the only fabric furniture is the sofa, which is mine, so that's my issue if that gets scratched. So anyway, I asked her and she said yes. So like I said, I've wanted a cat for ages, but I've always traveled so much that I just thought it wasn't the option for now. And I am still really need to think that bit through, because while travel isn't going to be part of our lives for a while, it will be again. And I need to make sure that I can, A, be at a point where like a friend could stay in my house when I was away and look after the cat. I've just looked, there are some catteries in East London as well, so should be manageable. And it would just be a case of, you know, last year I was away so much, so I wouldn't be able to travel as extensively as that because I'm just not here for a cat. But I think it would just make me really happy, and I really want one, and I want to adopt one, an older one, not too old that I'd only end up having it for a few years, probably from the age of 2 or 3 upwards. So I'm just looking at some cat shelters now. There's one here called Yoda, Shy X-ray. I would, the plus side about adopting an older cat, I think, is that you can get a sense of what their personality is a little bit. Like Mum's cat Daphne, bless Daphne, we just always call her a shit cat because she's not particularly affectionate, she's not particularly playful, she's not got very much personality. She just sleeps, eats, and stares at walls, literally within really close proximity. And even if she goes in the garden, she just goes outside and sits down somewhere. She doesn't do anything. And I guess that's a risk with a kitten. You don't know what they're going to be like. So, oh, there's one called Swiper, a playful boy who loves a snuggle. That's what I want. Something affectionate that will sit with me and cuddle up. Something that's really cheered me up, the thought of this. I just need to give a lot of thought to how, if life, when life is more normal, will I manage it? But I guess maybe it's one of those things that once you've got the cat, you make it work, and you have to make sure that you aren't away as much. And you know, a lot of the reason why I was traveling so much that particular year is because it was when Ben and I were together, so there was the long distance thing, whereas in normal years I would never normally travel that much. It's still a lot, but anyway, I want to share my exciting news with you all. Good morning, guys. I braved the flower market this morning. The first time in quite a while. Just getting my favourite mug out of the dishwasher. Which was quite busy. I didn't get up at the crack of dawn to go, but I did drag myself out of bed as soon as I woke up. So, one second, just doing a little tripod thing. So, it's taken me a while to get to grips with this tripod, sorry. So I did get there for about 9:15, and there was already quite a queue. So, dread to think how busy that'll be by 11. But anyway, quite nice to go, first time in so long. Now I'm just going to make myself a coffee and attempt some sort of a pancake because it's what I'm really craving. But anyone who's watched for a while might remember I did try this a few years ago and it was a disaster. So let's see where we get to today.
Thank you.
be honest, and I made far too much batter, but let's see how they actually taste. Tastes like cardboard with blueberries on it. I don't even like blueberries that much. Disastrous. Guys, good morning. I'm going to put some makeup on while I chat to you. It's Tuesday today. I don't even know how it's already got to be Tuesday. Just put the tripod down. I still haven't quite mastered how to do this smoothly for you all. Okay, we're on the tripod. Wow. There's a lot going on there, isn't there, with that hair. There's a lot going on. I'm actually going to go and get it coloured again on Friday at George Northwood again because I've got roots. Can you see? Which isn't normal for me. Because normally, well, this is probably the lightest I've ever dyed my hair. But also, I'm normally fortunate enough to kind of end up being in the sun throughout the year. And I've got the kind of hair that lightens up a lot in the sun, so it kind of keeps all the natural bit feeling blonder, but obviously I haven't been away, so it needs doing. So I think, like I said, I will go darker because I can't manage this upkeep. I also can't manage this tripod, just a second. Okay, that's much better. So yeah, I'm just gonna put a bit of makeup on. I'm just working today. I want to go and shoot some film and feel inspired about photography basically, and just walk around and get some photos taken. And sometimes I find that, like, I obviously haven't been inspired, and a lot of that is just from being stuck in the same place, but we all are experiencing that right now. And sometimes I find I just need to force myself to do it, and I might not like what I get, and that's fine. It might be a waste of a roll of film, but it will get my head back into it a bit, because my head hasn't been into shooting at all recently. So that's my morning plan. Just get some photos taken, Elizabeth. Do your job. And yeah, that's that really, just working. So cat updates. I have been frantically inquiring about cats in shelters all over London, and just waiting to hear back from them all basically. It is, well, it's not a slow process at all. I only put all the forms in on Friday. I'm just unbelievably impatient with it. I spoke to someone this morning, who'll hopefully get back to me this week. But all of the ones that I've spoken about, they say they've all got lots of interest in them. So it's a bit of a competition, I guess. But I just need to keep looking, keep an eye out for the kind of cat that I want, which is male, between 2 and 6 years old probably. I want one that can go outside, so it can't be FIV positive, so that it can go out. That's kind of it for my criteria. Aesthetically, I don't have one that I don't know for sure that I want a black cat or a ginger cat or anything. I'm not that bothered about that side. But quite a lot of them online do have things like FIV or other health problems, which I know it would be really good and really kind to take on a cat with some health problems, but I just know how much I worry all the time. I don't mind something small, like even if it was something like a three-legged cat. We used to have a three-legged cat called Neville. That would be fine. It's some of them I've been reading up, it says really openly this cat will need a lot of vet care throughout its life, and I just makes me feel sad instantly. So those are my criterias. I bought a travel basket yesterday so that if one comes up, I'm ready to go and collect my kitty, and hopefully that will happen in the next week or so. Because all of the forms, when you fill them out, they say, if you get accepted, are you ready to do this within 3 days? So it's really quick. I think the long bit is getting accepted. So fingers crossed, because I just can't stop thinking about it, and I'm so excited about the thought of having another cat around here. I need to go get a litter tray. Like I said, I'll let it out. I want one that can go out, but because all the gardens at the back of where I live up there, all are interlocked, so it's really hard for them to get onto the road. I actually don't know how they would do it unless they climbed over the houses, which is a cat, so you can't rule that out. But so the back's quite safe for cats because it's not near any busy roads. So I want one that can go out for that reason. But anyhow, I need to get a litter tray because obviously when I first get it, it won't be a good idea to let it out straight away. So I need to get a litter tray and some litter and maybe some toys and things. So I might do a little trip to Pets at Home or something later or tomorrow, depending on where I get to work stuff today. Actually, there are some local pet shops too. I wouldn't necessarily have to drive out to one. So yes, that's my cat update. What's this weird flicky fringe we've got going on? And I'm very, very, very excited about it. And we'll just keep you guys updated, but I don't think there'll be any more big updates in this vlog, as it should, the vlog will be up tomorrow and it's already Tuesday. This is how I deal with my fringe when it's flicky. It's a really high maintenance and skilled operation. Damp and brush. God, I need a fringe trim. I'll also get that done this week, hopefully. Oh, okay. Good evening, guys. As you can see, coming to the boudoir. Oh, watching to the wall. Here to talk to you about this little alarm clock. So, just take off my sexy Birkenstocks. Excuse the earplugs on the floor. Loud TV lady is my nemesis. So I got, this isn't sponsored by the way, I thought this is the kind of thing that could feel sponsored, it's not. I bought the Google Hub, I'll link it because I've forgotten its exact name, Home Hub, Google Hub Nest, Google Nest Home Hub is my alarm clock. As you can see, it's definitely bedtime. This is quite a late time for me to see in the day. I've already set my alarm, which you do by just asking it to do it. But you can do all sorts of things. So you get the news, you connect your Spotify, you can get your YouTube. These are the play relaxing sounds. Let's just, you can, if you are someone who has more of a routine than someone like me, basically if you're not self-employed, I guess, you can put your like, gentle sounds of an oscillating what? Fan. That is the sound of a fan. I don't want that on. You can like set up to, it tells you the commute, or so go, hey Google, what's the weather doing tomorrow?
Tomorrow in London, it'll be rainy with a high of 16 and a low of 12.
I like this. So anyway, those are the features of it. It was like £70 or £80 or something. It was very reasonable, I think, that does this much. So I'm liking the fact I can watch a YouTube video if I want to do that before I go to sleep, and I'm leaving my phone downstairs. But it's so good in the morning because my alarm goes off and then I just sort of have to get up. I don't have to rely on my phone to start stimulating my mind, which it doesn't do, and lay in bed for another half an hour. And this goes off, maybe I snooze it, I lie there, and then I'm like, well, now you could get up. And it sounds so obvious, but I think lots of us will relate to this, of it. We're so dependent on our phones as part of routines, but it's not healthy routines. So that's there. And when you turn the light off, it also goes really dark, so it doesn't light up the room or anything at night. But I'm really, really, really pleased with it and really recommend it. And I'm now going to go to bed. Morning guys, I look rough, it's good. Momentarily given up on the tripod. My, my coffee machine fused last night. I was actually not sat working, that's a lie. I was loading the dishwasher and I hadn't plugged anything in, I hadn't changed anything, and all of a sudden all the lights went out, all the plugs went off. That's just gone off for some reason. And it was one of those things where I don't know what point I'd be an adult enough where I can just deal with this without calling mum. But I had to ring mum and be like, mum, all the lights have gone off. I don't know how to on. Anyway, I had to unplug everything in the house. Mum knew what to do, of course. I had to unplug everything in the house and then, oh, this is twisted. And then plug everything in one by one until I could work out what it was that was blowing the fuse. Anyway, it was the coffee machine. So that's been unplugged. And I've asked for one for my birthday, a new one. So until then, we're on cafetières. Just one of those things. So that I must work out how to dispose of that. I guess I will have to take it to an electrical disposal place, which I will do. I am just, I'm going to go upstairs. I'm just finishing getting ready. I've got counselling this morning at 11. It's about 10:30 now. I'm sat doing a bit of work. Now I'm going to rest. Balance you precariously on a candle. I put some fake tan on my face last night. You can definitely tell it looks, well, actually it looks pretty orangey yellow in real life as well as on camera, so that's great. That went well. So yeah, gonna get a new coffee machine. I just edited through this vlog and it's a long one, it's very chatty, which I hope you don't mind. I think I might try and shoot something a bit different for next week. Also do vlogs as well, but maybe something like a nice little short moody video to break up how much you will have listened to me yabber on this week. And I'm obviously here to sign this out so that I can then edit it and get this uploaded for you guys. So thank you so much for watching. Obviously I'll keep you all very updated on whatever cat updates come my way. As of now there are none. I had to send over a video of my house and garden to the RSPCA yesterday. My concern is that, like I said, everything's in quite high demand and all of the branches are outside of London, and so I think I will be competing with people who probably have bigger houses and bigger gardens. And obviously their RSPCA are going to do, already cat shelter, are going to put the cat where they think the cat's the best match and can offer the best lifestyle for the cat. And I don't know that I'll be able to compete with people with big gardens, basically. So I'm not overly hopeful, but still crossing fingers and keep looking for different ones too. And I will keep you guys in the loop as well throughout the next week with what is going on with all of this. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. This has been a super, 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 super chatty vlog, which I hope you don't mind. And I promise some more fashion content soon. I've literally worn the same outfit day in, day out this week, so I really wouldn't have offered very much to you on that front for this week. But I promise to do some more fashion content soon, and I will see you in the next one.